Good morning. Please stand for the class of 2024. Seated. What? I'm already being told to stop and I haven't even started speaking. Okay, here we go. Good morning and welcome to the OTA pinning for the class of 2024. I love this class if you can't tell. I am Piper Sessman. I am assistant professor and program director of the program. I want to thank each of you for being here today. Your presence and support of these graduates are part of the reason we are here today. Thank you for all the support you provided them, whether it was a form of being a simulated client, emotional support, financial support, or a listening ear when they had all of those templates to complete, competencies to pass, another quiz on colored paper, or heard trust the process for the millionth time. At this time, I would like to introduce the individuals on the stage with me today. Dr. Shauna Jackson, President of Nashville State Community College. Dr. Joe Williams, Vice President of Academic Affairs and Workforce Development. Donna Whitehouse, Dean of Health Sciences. Cindy Morgan, Assistant Professor and Academic Fieldwork Coordinator. And Dr. Lynn Worf, an Adjunct Faculty. Support from you makes all of this possible. I would also like to take the time to give a huge thank you to the people behind the scenes that make my job a lot easier, especially on days like today. Jenny Heath, Administrative Assistant, School of Health Sciences, David Crawford and Gabe from Computer Services, the Nashville State Maintenance, Housekeeping, and Security Departments, and our current second year students that helped us set up today and will be directing you for the rest of this afternoon. At this time, I would like to welcome Dr. Jackson to say a few words.
Well, good morning. Today is a day of celebration. Students, class of 2024, congratulations. You did it. You did it. You worked hard, you took the test on colored paper assignments, and you've made Miss Simpson, she's been crying like this whole morning because she said you all are special, and I believe that. I want you to think back to that moment you decided to apply to the OTA program, how you were feeling, and then when you got that text, email, or phone call saying you were in. And then the reality sets in. This is a lot of hard work to get where you are. You are certainly joining a very noble profession. You are going to help a lot of people. And so I do want to welcome all of our guests, the family and friends, and I see faculty and staff are with us today. Thank you for being here. I know that no one gets through this journey by themselves, and so I know they had a lot of help from you and support. We are excited to celebrate your accomplishments today and very proud. And I heard I'm going to see many of you tonight as well at commencement. I want you to remember your experience, and I want you to be committed to giving back. We want you to do very well in your profession because I know you're well prepared to do so. But don't forget your Falcons and now your soon-to-be alums. So congratulations, class of 2024.
Dr. Williams.
Good Good morning. I'm Joe Williams, Vice President of Academic Affairs and Workforce Development, and it is an honor to be here to congratulate you all today and to celebrate you and your accomplishments. It's really interesting when you think about what you guys have planned to do and what you've worked so hard for. And when you put this much time and effort and work into being qualified enough to serve other people, that is an amazing thing to commit yourself to, an amazing accomplishment. Everything that you've done since you first set foot in that first classroom has been so that you can help someone else. The time, the energy, the effort, the money, your family's commitment and support has been so that you can help and serve someone else. That is really something to be proud of. I'm very proud of you. I appreciate the faculty who have sort of helped guide you through this path. They've had a hand in the help that you're going to provide others. The staff at the college, your families, everyone's been involved so that you can, that will culminate into this day. And it's a very proud time for you and for us at the college. So as you get out there in the world to do all the great things you're going to do, remember that you are serving other people and how grateful those people are to have you. Congratulations, and we're very proud of you.
Ms. Whitehouse.
Hi. It's hard to believe that you're here. For those of you that don't know, in the middle of the semester for this particular class, I transitioned role from a faculty member for this class into the dean for the School of Health Sciences. This class was gracious, they were understanding, they were supportive, they were engaged, they were excited for me, they were excited for the school in the direction that we were headed. They take that enthusiasm, they take that knowledge, they take that experience as we move forward. But today, what I wanted to do is I wanted to thank you, because you, after about 27 years, maybe, as an educator, you are right now the last class that I have in the classroom. And the fact that you were so engaged and so thrilled to be here, and you demonstrated enthusiasm for the profession, and you were a partner in education, not just a student teacher, but you collaborated, you asked questions, you were curious, you wanted to not just be a student, you demonstrated that you wanted to grow as a professional. As an educator, what a gift you gave to me as my last class as an occupational therapy educator. And so I wanted to thank you today for that. And I know that you will take that passion as you move forward in your career, and that you will take that to your future patients. And I am thrilled to have been just a small part of your journey to this point, and I look forward to where you go next. So thank you for that gift. And as my colleagues have said today, don't forget where you came from. I know you won't. And come back and visit often. And I look forward as you also take on the role of educator for our future students. So you don't need it, but best of luck where you're going. And I look forward to following you on that journey. So thank you.
Ms. Morgan is going to come introduce the student class officers. When she says your name, if you could just stand up where you're seated.
Hello, class of 2024. It's been a pleasure to serve alongside you in the SOTA organization. We did a lot of community service and events, and so appreciative. So if you can stand, President Erica DeLangen. Vice President Mary Troy Gutierrez. Treasurer Joyce B. Cooten. Historian Dallas Hottenwanger. And Maria Campo. SGA representative, Brandon Hobson. Special Projects Chair, Edessa Williams. And I really practiced that name and I don't want to mess it up. Edessa? Edessa. All right. I tried. All right. TNOTA representative, Joshua Judas. SOTA Hotline, Sarah Winslick. All right. Thank you all. Again, it was a pleasure serving with you. And congratulations.
We've been practicing these last names for quite some time. Okay. I looked at them, so I shouldn't have looked at them. Okay, as program director, I typically do not teach the new incoming students during the first semester of the program. I follow their progress through conversations with other professors and gradually get to know the students over the semester with what I call pulse checks, meaning I meet with the students and just check on them and make sure they didn't need anything from me. I remember asking Ms. Morgan if there was anything I needed to address with the students, like attendance, professionalism, turning in assignments on time, and she said, "No, this class is great. You are going to have so much fun with them." I was like, "Well, this is awesome," and I really also didn't know what to think. As we continue through the program, I realized that you are an amazing class. Everyone on this campus knew how we felt about you. I remember during our IADL meal event, I was talking to Dr. Jackson and bragging on everyone, and she looked at me and said, "You are going to really cry when this class leaves, aren't you?" And I was like, I said, "Yes, ma'am, I am." So I want to tell you in the audience a little bit about this class. This class consists of students that work part-time and full-time during the program, single parents, students that started and maybe ended situationships and relationships. Two have become mamas within the last few weeks. One is about to become a mama, and the program's first ever married couple. And even with all the things, they always showed up to class on time and prepared. They always held themselves, each other, and even us accountable. They always focused on the feedback and not the grade. And they always had questions. But because of all of these things, we were able to bring back meal events to campus, create a collaboration with our nursing department, and add on to our collaboration with Belmont's occupational therapy program. Now, individually, these are some of our favorite memories. And you're going to see some of these pictures at the reception. Oh, God. I have the mic now. Okay. Sarah A. We were sitting outside of the classroom one day during a very long week during competencies, and we looked at each other and just said, "We've got this." Shauna and Kelly's transfer comp, which was a hilarious disaster. We were all crying, but for different reasons. Maria always taking pictures so that everyone is represented today. Logan becoming Lolo in our system. Erica's tenacity as our class president and acting skills during demos. Josh messaging me during his level one at Skyline, telling me that he knew then that this was the profession for him. Mayor Troy being a leader in the classroom and in our Student Success Center. Dallas, also known as Dalla, with her creative ideas, including a weighted cape. Brandon really wanting to learn the words to Rocky Top and the Woo Pig Suey dance, but never wanting to admit it. Cabrina and the burnt popcorn. Amy, never wanting to make eye contact with me when I was asking for volunteers, but that one time she did, and it was over from there. Joyce always being willing to help faculty and other classmates, including Brandon during interviews when Cabrina would not. Christine being identified as one of the best students I have ever had in her pediatric setting. Kendall telling us that Mr. Landon was on his way, or telling me, no, don't tell me, I got this during one of her comps. Eddie owning the task of being a simulated patient during events. Emmy always giving the most well-thought-out answers to our questions. Us wondering what story Colin would tell about what Alfie, his dog, ate over the weekend, including his computer, his textbook, or his homework. And there are pictures to prove it's actually all true. Sierra S. making the best swag for everyone. You really thought I was going to say something about questions, didn't you? Mm-hmm. Jordan's dance skills that you will see here shortly. Hannah telling me that she had a secret during her functional mobility practicum and that it was Miss Emerson was on her way. Alyssa messaging me that she was sad to leave one of her patients in level 2A. Sarah W. coming to tell us that Miss Ida Maxine is on her way this summer. And Sierra W.'s hidden sass coming out during event training. And Anna always having her coffee and snacks, even during the tow truck incident. Our profession is just not about helping people do daily tasks. It's about making them feel important and worthwhile. So when you're working with patients in the future, always remember to take a holistic and purposeful approach. So I brought this today. This is a letter that Colin was given by one of his patients, one of the very last days of his level 2B. This patient has a PhD in gerontology and also has advanced stage dementia. You cannot read the words on this because they are so small, but she wanted to do something for him, and it made her feel purposeful. It made her feel useful. So I asked Colin to let me have a copy of this, and it's actually going to be hung up in our new space. So we always remember your why. For you as a person and a clinician, we always want you to remember your why. Keep your balance in your life. Trust the process in every aspect of your life. And if you ever feel cattywampus in life, always remember that we are your biggest cheerleaders. Thank you for being Ms. Whitehouse's last class and for renewing mine and Ms. Morgan's spirit for teaching. We are excited to welcome you into our profession and know that you will make your future patients, your support system, and this whole world a better place. So now I would like to welcome Erica, our class president, to the stage.
Good morning. Thank you, Dr. Sesnin. Occupational therapy. When I hear these words, occupational therapy, I think of many different things. I think of healing, helping others, independence, problem solving, creativity, and our awesome teachers reminding us time and time again to trust the process. I didn't know you were going to say that. Now I understand why. After spending almost 2 years in this life-changing occupational therapy assistant program with these incredible people, my classmates and teachers, it is very clear that not only did we choose this profession, but this profession chose us. For different reasons and inspirations, occupational therapy called us. It has been an incredible journey full of knowledge, growth, challenges, perseverance, unforgettable memories. And it seems like just yesterday we were walking into class for the first time. And here we are now at our pinning ceremony. We did it, yay. And now it is time for us to take everything we've learned, share our talents and gifts, and go out there to help make a positive difference in people's lives. To my classmates, The kindness, the dedication, the commitment and resilience that you radiate is forever inspiring. And to my teachers, thank you for your constant encouragement, your wisdom, and your grace. It was an honor to be on this journey with you all. And last but not least, thank you all so much to the family and all the friends in person or watching elsewhere. Your support means the world. Thank you so much. Thank you.
And now we have a video presentation.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain.
At this time, I would like to recognize three students that received individual awards during their time in the program. The first two students received a $1,000 scholarship from the Nashville State Community College Foundation office. The recipients had to interview with our advisory board. In the past, only one student received this award, but this cycle, our advisory board asked that both students receive this award. The recipients were Maria Campo and Cabrina Hobson. The second award is the OTA Program Academic and Leadership Award. This award is a peer-nominated award. The criteria for the award is exceptional academic performance, participation in student club activities, advocacy for patients in a profession. This student was honored at an award ceremony a couple of weeks ago, but Mayor Troy, can you please go ahead and come up here as well? Here at Nashville State, we have a program called the SOAR program that seeks to develop leaders on campus and better prepare our students for post-graduation. This leadership program emphasizes service learning, student involvement, goal setting, as well as career readiness. Graduates with this SOAR distinction have demonstrated the completion of a well-rounded education from Nashville State and a commitment to their future. I am happy to say that all of our graduates have met these requirements and will be graduating with leadership distinction. They will be receiving a certificate, an honor cord, and Nashville swag for all of their accomplishments. So without further ado, Sierra S., are you ready for you and your classmates to get pinned?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm going to call the graduates up, and as they are walking up, I'm going to announce who will be pinning them today. Sarah Alcantar. Her mom will be pinning her today.
I just want to thank my family for supporting me through all of this and for my teachers who helped me get here even when I thought I couldn't.
Shauna Bronner and her kids will be pinning her today.
I'm like speechless for the first time ever. I truly believe that God handpicked each and every one of us for this class. I was remembering my application and interview, I also was remembering I didn't make the program. I was actually waitlisted, 15 out of 15, so there would have to have been 15 positions that had opened up for even a chance. And somehow God saw it for me to have a seat in this class, and I know a lot of my friends here also are waitlisted, but we're here for such a time as this, and we did it, and we made it. This is one of the hardest things I've ever done, but one of the most beautiful. I love you all so much. And thanks to my kids for sacrificing so much for me.
Maria Campo and her parents will be pinning her.
I just want to thank everybody that supported me through this process and who believed in me even when I didn't believe in myself.
Welcome. I got you. She's nervous.
Logan Colvin, and her boyfriend Owen will be pinning her.
Maria, thank you for lowering this for me. I just knew I wasn't going to be able to reach this when I got up here. Last night as I was driving, I was trying to rehearse in my head what I was going to say when I got up here, but God has laid it very, very heavy on my heart that I need to pray over you all. So if you would allow me to do that, I would love for you to bow your heads. God, I thank you for letting us gather here safely to celebrate all of my wonderful classmates. I pray that you give me the words that the people in this room need to hear. I pray that you place your healing hands on all of those suffering right now, whether we know about it or not, whether it's physical or mental. Please provide them with strength and comfort to get through this day. I thank you for my wonderful classmates and our teachers and all the support in this room and guiding us through this process. And I pray that from here on out, we will do your work in this life and not our own selfish desires. And we love you, and it's in your name we pray. Amen.
Erica DeLangen. Erica has asked me and Miss Morgan to pin her.
Just want to say thank you all so much, and I really want to thank my family for making the drive from Chicago and my amazing husband. I share this moment with you all, and I couldn't have done this without your support. I love you all so much. Thank you.
Kelly Field, and she has asked Ms. Morgan and I to pin her.
Wow, what a ride. We did it, you guys. I just want to thank everyone for being here today in the last 2 years. We could not have done it without you, and I want to say thank you to my teachers. You guys are the best.
Joshua Judas, and he's asked Ms. Morgan and I to pin him.
All right, I would just like to say thank you to all of my professors and classmates for all of your help and support.
Mary Troy Gutierrez. Oh, her husband is pinning her. Thank you, Dallas.
I just want to thank all the faculty here for not only growing me as a professional, but also in my personal life, making me closer to the person I aspire to be. So thank you.
Dallas Halterwanger, and her son Henry is going to pin.
I didn't cry until we ran down the aisle. I just want to say thank you to my friends, to my family, to my boss at the daycares. They have let me take off work so many times. She's on live right now, so Miss T, I love you. And to my professors, thank you.
Brandon Hobson. His wife will be pinning him in just a minute.
I would just like to thank my wife for supporting me throughout this program. Thank my classmates, thank my professors, and I would like to send a special thanks to Ms. Whitehouse for letting me come and observe a long time ago. I didn't realize I would be here, but thank y'all, and I appreciate y'all.
Cabrina Hobson, and she will be pinned by her husband, Brandon.
I want to say thank you to my family and friends for supporting me and my husband through this program. And I want to thank my amazing professors for bringing us here and making everything possible. Thank you all so much. You have been such a blessing to both of us. Thank you.
Brandon. Up here telling him how to do it, by the way. Jones. She will be pinned by her daughter.
I want to thank my family and friends and my professors for making this happen.
Thank you. I've done it again. Oh, you're good. Joyce B. Cooten, and her family will be pinning her.
Hello, family, that I've got it here. Thank you all. Thank you, my wonderful classmates, for seeing me through it all. And then most of all, I would like to thank my professors and then my family who are watching online and then the ones that are here. They were my ITs. You see, I have some college students and they really helped me along the way. Thank you.
Christine Landenberger and her husband and kids will be pinning her.
I just want to say thank you to the faculty and my classmates and my table girls. I'm going to miss you, but we did it.
Kendall McDaniel, she has asked me and Miss Morgan to pin her.
I just wanted to thank Dr. Sesnin and Miss Morgan for all their accommodations and flexibility to get me here to the pinning ceremony.
Adisa Mendoza Williams and her husband and kids will be pinning her.
I'm grateful to have family and friends that have supported and motivated me on this journey. To keep this speech short, I will only name a few. I want to say thank you to my daughter, Araya, for her kindness. On long days, she would fix me a snack plate. Thank you to my son, Orion. He motivated me in more ways than what he knows. On my tired days, he would always bring a smile to my face. Thank you to my darling husband for always believing in me. You don't have to pretend to be my patient anymore. To my parents, para mis papás. No hay ningún acto que pueda hacer que pueda agradecerles lo suficiente por todos los sacrificios que ambos han hecho, pero espero que este los demuestre la, lo agradecida y lo orgullosa que soy de ser su hija.
Emery Phillips, and she has asked me to pin her.
I just want to say thank you to my family and all the amazing staff that's on this stage and even the ones that aren't here today. You guys have been such a support in my life. And I also want to just say thank you to my four girls right here. You guys were the most fun table ever, and we made some unforgettable memories, and I will cherish them forever. I just want to say a special thank you to Dr. Sesnin, because she truly has been amazing through this process. And before every single comp or skills check off, she would look at me and say, "Emmy, I'm not worried about you." And that meant everything to me, and I think it truly helped me to get where I am today. So I just want to say thank you.
Colin Poche and his mom is going to pin him.
I just want to thank everyone that's helped support me, my friends, family, classmates, and y'all have helped me and pushed me, and most importantly, y'all have put up with me for the last 2 years. So. I greatly appreciate that. Thank y'all.
Sierra Sadler and her friend Joelle is going to pin her.
I just wanted to say thank you to my family and my friends and my classmates for your endless support, and thank you to my professors for always answering my questions.
Jordan Seacrest and her parents and brother will be pinning her.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you, first of all, to the Lord for this incredible journey. Thank you to my professors and all of the OTA staff that has helped me along the way. Thank you to my lovely classmates. You all have made this a very enjoyable experience. And thank you to my mom, my brother, and my dad for always supporting me in all of my endeavors. You all can come on now.
Hannah Stafford, and she has asked me to pin her.
I wish I had somebody lower this, but it's okay. I just wanted to thank everyone who has supported me, especially my classmates. Y'all have been amazing. I don't know what I'm going to do without y'all now.
Alyssa Watson, and her parents are going to pin her.
I just want to say thank you to my friends and family for supporting me and putting up with my endless rants about all the things I had to do. And to my classmates, you guys have been so amazing, and the professors as well. Y'all were so supportive, and so you just made this process so much better, and I'm so thankful. Thank you, guys.
Sarah Winslick and her husband Chris will pin her.
Two years ago, I was also waitlisted, not in the program yet.
I was very unsure what I was going to do with my life. I just started dating this really great guy. And here we are 2 years later. I have made it through this program with the help of all of my fabulous classmates and my professors and my wonderful husband. And shortly, we're expecting our little baby girl. God has such bigger plans than I ever could have imagined. And I know that's true for myself and for all of you. And I'm so glad I got to do this with you guys. So, yeah, thank you.
Sierra Winsack and her dad is going to pin her.
Thank you to my friends and family for all the support and my table of four ladies. Love y'all. And thank you for my dad for being my patient during all this. And I wish y'all the best of luck. Congratulations.
Anna Wilson. Her family friend Carrie will be pinning her.
Hi, everyone. I can't think of better words to say than I love you all. Thank you, everyone, for being there for me. And y'all have been the best support. Dr. Sessnan, you went out of your way for me before the program ever started. I didn't know what occupational therapy was. I'm very glad to be here. Thank you very much.
So graduates, if you can grab a program, they should be under your seat. Graduates, can you please stand? We're going to do the pledge. If everybody else wants to stand as they are reciting their pledge, please do so. Okay, graduates, one last teaching comp, okay? I'm going to say the section, and then you say the section, okay? Okay. We'll show you, and then we do it together, right? Okay. Only the OTs in the room know what we're talking about here. I pledge and commit myself to the ethical, responsible, and diligent practice of my profession. I will respect and uphold the laws that govern my profession and adhere to its ethical principles. I pledge faithfully to honor the inherent dignity of all, to treat those who depend on my help with respect, consideration, and appreciation for our diversities.
I pledge,
I pledge always to protect the rights and confidentiality of those who seek my help, and to act only for their benefit. I pledge continually to strive to learn, to further my professional competence, and to share my knowledge with those who seek it. I pledge always to serve to the best of my ability, to conduct myself with dignity, and to place service to humankind before personal or material gain. With honor and pride, I commit myself to my profession. So please welcome the graduates of the 2024 class of the OTA program. So we are going to be celebrating the graduates at a reception. So some of our second year students are in the back and going to help you get to the reception. But the easiest way is if you will go out these doors right here and to the right, go all the way through the breezeway, watch out for the cicadas. And I'm sorry, they're there. And just walk into the W building. Like I said, we have students that are going to help you get there. And thank you all for coming, and congratulations.